Hello and welcome to Downtown Alive, the monthly TV show of the Reading Downtown Improvement District Authority. And like I try to remind everyone in the beginning of our shows, I wanted to let you know that again, the Reading Downtown Improvement District is focused on creating a vital, productive, and commercially active environment in downtown Reading. DID, which we're proudly called for short, provides cleaning, security, and marketing services for a specially designated commercial district in the city, and also sponsors several events and activities throughout the year, including midday cafes, the Reading Holiday Parade, the Reading Fire and Ice Fest. DID continually strives to make downtown Reading a cleaner, safer, and more inviting place to live, work, and visit. And hi, once again, I'm Cindy Kauffman, your host for this evening. And we have a really nice show for you tonight. Joining me is Heidi Williamson. She's Vice President of Programs and Initiatives for the Berks County Community Foundation. And we have Joe Giardano from SMG Santander Arena, and then a list of all kinds of other things under that. And you wear lots of hats in that organization.
Yeah, you know, it could be called Cat in the Hat or, you know, something like that at this point.
But Joe's going to help talk to us a little bit about some of the fun things that are coming up in the city of Reading. But I wanted to start the show with Heidi today. Berks County Community Foundation has really stepped up to play a huge part of what's changing in downtown Reading. And I thought maybe you'd like to give us a little bit of background about the organization, you know, its mission, and you've been very active in helping us do the kind of development that we're doing in downtown. So let us know about Berks County Community Foundation.
Sure. Well, the Community Foundation was started back in 1994 to help people who want to do something charitable in the community. And usually what happens is that someone really cares about a cause or an organization, and they've been supporting an organization for a long time or supporting a cause for a long time, and they want to set aside some money to make sure that that cause or organization continues to be supported in perpetuity, so forever. So we work with people to help them do that. And then a lot of times they'll end up setting up a charitable fund to help with whatever that is, and then we'll manage the money that's in the fund and then provide grants or sometimes scholarships, depending on the type of fund, exactly how that donor intended. So that's our day-to-day work. That's what we do. How we got involved in the downtown revitalization, we've actually been talking for years and years about the revitalization of Penn Street and how it really is so important to Berks County to have a vibrant Penn Street. And in the past few years, we've been able to take some of what we've learned in other communities and other cities where they've tried to have activities downtown that bring lots of people in. And once you have enough people and enough activities and enough kind of a drumbeat of activities, some that are regularly scheduled and then some that are special events, it starts to attract private investment. First of all, it helps the businesses that are already there, because Correct. There are a lot of great businesses that are already on Penn Street. But then it also helps to draw enough people in to have more businesses that want to be part of the community. So the Community Foundation learned about what worked in these other towns, and we had a fund that was created, the Holly and Myrtle Queer Fund at the Community Foundation. And that is primarily an undesignated fund where our board says, here are some important things in the community we'd like you to support with the grant making from this fund. So when Mrs. Queer passed away, that fund came to the Community Foundation as a bequest, and the grants that have been made to the DID to help support some of this programming that's been happening came from that fund. So that's really how we got involved. The board said, let's really do what we can to support the revitalization of Penn Street, and we can put some funding behind it.
Well, the foundation has certainly grown over the 20 plus years that mm-hmm. it's been in the community, and you have a beautiful office building that's really environmentally mm-hmm. A masterpiece and a real step in that direction. But I think we all agree that it is a very important step to invest in the downtown, because regardless of where you live in the county, it's you're going to be affected by what goes on in the city. Mm-hmm. It's really the hub of what goes on. And to be able to have some of the things that you've been able to bring gets people there, and then they enjoy it and they come back. Mm-hmm. And that's really what we're starting to see. And we're having a blast doing this stuff, too. I know last year with the Fire and Ice Fest was one of the first initiatives that on a large scale like that, that we had in the outside and in the cold, and mm-hmm. it worked. I mean, we said one of the things that we looked at was that Friday night at 10 o'clock on 5th and Penn, we had live music and people dancing, and that was a good sign.
Right.
That said, you know what, this does work, and we can make it happen, and going to do it again this year.
And it's really something. If people haven't had a chance to come down to Penn Street when a block is closed or when a couple of blocks are closed, it's amazing to see how big that space is. And it really is the county's downtown. It's the county's main street. And you can see that it was built for that type of activity, for commercial activity, for events, for people to get together. So the Fire and Ice Festival, that was a pilot project. We wanted to see, well, if we shut the street down, what'll happen? And it worked. It was very successful. So that led to the idea of doing, well, let's try a pilot program to do some concerts this summer and see if that brings people downtown. And we've also been supporting the Redesign Reading program with the farmers market. So that's in every week the farmer's market is happening and people are starting to come back and connect.
And they're expanding things with their urban
bistro
mm-hmm. and so some things downtown. So you can come down and sit and eat outside and enjoy some of the farmer fresh foods. And I think that a lot of things are moving in the right direction. And talking about large events and music, we have to bring Joe in with that. We had last month we had Striking Matches.
Yep.
And that was our first one mm-hmm. In this arena that we looked at. And I think we all looked at it and said, we'll crawl. And we know that there's probably things that we're going to have to change, or not large things, because we all were expert enough to know what has to happen. Mm-hmm. But there might be little twerks and tweaks and different things that have to happen. And I think we were all surprised at how well it all worked. And the amount of people, we were pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, I think the buzz off the concert afterwards was so positive that it was just really refreshing. You know, to see something like that, you know, which, you know, we've been meeting about and talking about for a while now, and then to put Striking Matches on the stage, and the band was so supportive of it, you know, when realizing what it was and realizing what it represented, you know, the first of many, which it will be. So, you know, the band was great, you know, the people who came out, thank you, you know, it's very, very cool that you did that. You know, it might be your genre of music, it might not be, you know, there are people, you know, from all different demographics, and, you know, it was cool to have everybody celebrate, you know, music in downtown Reading, and seeing, like Heidi said, you know, the street shut down, how big it is, and, you know, you really get that, you know, that giddy feel, I guess, you know, once you see something like that happen. And, you know, with all the, you know, negativity out there these days and everything like that, bad press or whatever, that was just such a shining moment, I guess, in Berks County, and just kind of a, you know, this is starting to happen. So.
Well, it was nice because the staging was professional. I mean, people, if they come down, I mean, this was a first-class stage. I mean, it was what you would see out in a professional field. The group that you were able to get in, Striking Matches, had some kind of local connection, but at the same time, they're out there in the professional field. And we had a beer garden, mm-hmm. but it wasn't one that was roped in or chained in. You could actually walk around Penn Street within the 500 block and enjoy a beer. And we had some food vendors, so you could have some pork barbecue and some different foods. So it was really a very comfortable and very memorable evening for a lot of us. We left there thinking, yes, this is really good. And we're looking at the next one now in September.
Yep.
Yeah. And this one should be twice as good.
Yeah, this one should be much bigger. It's Andrew McMahon in the Wilderness. He is, you know, a national touring artist. He's been in bands called Jack's Mannequin and Something Corporate. If you're not familiar with either one of them, you know, ask anybody in the range of maybe 21 to 25 or 26, and that is kind of the niche and genre that he, you know, appeals to. It's really kind of like the college market, college kids, and you know, I will say that he has the history with that crowd, but he definitely will entertain and keep everybody on their feet dancing and singing along. You know, even if you don't know the songs now, you will by the end of his set, because he's got such good energy. He's performed at, you know, huge festivals, you know, all year round, and he's always touring. He's actually touring with his family. He's got a song out, his biggest hit right now, called Cecilia and Satellite. Is about his little baby Cecilia, so she tours with him, you know. So it's a cool experience to have Andrew in town, and what an opportunity for us too for our second concert to really build on what we did the first time. So we were proud to land that one. He's playing, you know, venues like the Fillmore in Philadelphia. That's, you know, a brand new venue, and they don't just bring anybody into that venue, you know, for the first time. So, you know, it's going to be one of those experiences that if you didn't get out to the first one, if you're curious about what this is, you know, make sure you come out to this one, because I will say the atmosphere is going to be festival-like. We'll have all kind of the same elements
and
to it, and a big artist.
We didn't tell them how much it costs.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, it's free. yeah, all these concerts are completely free. I think that's one of the coolest things about it. You know, we, as soon as we posted this one particularly, it was like, Andrew McMahon playing a free show in my city. How close? You know, like all this stuff. It's just been so interactive.
And we've had a lot of contacts from outside the county.
Right.
And
yeah.
That just goes to show that he has a good draw. I happen to say that I've listened to some of his music, and it's really very entertaining. Very enjoyable to listen to.
He's very enjoyable, and you know, the cool part as well is that he's got he's a 10-year cancer-free survivor, which is one of the coolest parts about him. He has this foundation that's one of his more ambitious, I guess, ventures, you know, in his career, but it's a huge foundation. It's called the Dear Jack Foundation. So if you know, have a chance, you know, look it up. It's one of the coolest things about, you know, what he represents. He really appreciates everything that's been given to him, you know, just from his past experiences at such a young age too. So
well, we're sold. We're going to have food and beer again.
Yep.
And we expect lots of people. So they come one down to 5th and Penn on September 23rd.
Yep.
5 o'clock.
5 o'clock.
We have an opening act, and then Andrew will be on, and you're sure to walk away feeling really wonderful about the whole event.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a great package, and it's been a real good thing about all the cooperation that we all have put together. This isn't something that DID could do alone. This maybe isn't something that SMG would tackle on their own, and we've been able to partner and really show that that's the future. It's got to be a lot of partnerships and different things to make things work.
And some other folks in the city have too. So one of the things about these concerts, there's free parking in the Cherry Street garage for folks. And the parking, even if you want to park at a meter, the meters are done at 6 o'clock, so you're really only paying the meter for 1 hour. So that's one thing. You know, people wonder, well, where should I park when I come into the city? There's definitely parking available in the garages and on the street.
And so you can bring your own chair. We don't provide any seating of any kind, except that some of the food areas we do have some tables and chairs, but bring your seat, blanket, be comfortable, you know.
Umbrella if it's raining, it's a rain or shine show.
Rain or shine.
Exactly.
And bring your dancing shoes, right?
Oh yeah.
We're gonna see Joe dance?
Maybe. No, but to, you know, to go back to, you know, a point about what this means as well, the industry itself looks at these kinds of things, you know, whether it be something that starts like we are and builds into a huge festival or something like that. You know, promoters and things like that look to cities to see, you know, what they've got going on downtown and what they can add to customer experience and you know, what downtown looks like in general on event days. So, you know, if you're just not sure about it or something like that, you know, get out there and try it out, because the more support we have will mean the more, you know, entertainment and things in the future. It really will. So, you know, I encourage everybody to check it out because it will lead to bigger, you know, and better things.
Well, we're up there and walking now, and I think till October we'll be running. With October 24th, we have the Gin Blossoms. We'll just kind of tease everybody with that. That's going to be in the 700 block of Penn from about 4 to 6, that time frame.
Yeah, 4 to 6. It's right before the Reading Royals opening night, actually, this year.
It sounds like till we're all said and done from the last meeting we had, we're going to have a whole day of activities and fun. Yeah. So plan to keep October 24th for Reading Royals and concerts and all kinds of fun things downtown. First of all, thank you for all that you do. And we have a lot of things going on. This weekend is our Reading Bike 120 race. It's going to be huge. It's going to be all over the county. We'll be downtown, of course. This is an opportunity also to highlight some of the things that DID has been preparing for some of these things. We have our wayfinding maps that are at the corners, and there is a QR cube on there, so you can take a shot of that and get it on your phone and find out information and, you know, where's the local restaurants and different things that you might want to know on that map. So those are fun things to be able to get to. We're also getting ready for, and you need to get your forms filled out, we have a scarecrow contest coming up. We're going to decorate downtown for the fall. We're going to put some corn shocks and hay bales and pumpkins, and eventually, you know, this could lead into a whole pumpkin festival in the fall. And we're getting some scarecrows. So it's families, organizations, church groups, businesses. Enter your scarecrow. Nothing scary and ugly, that kind of thing. These are fun, family-friendly scarecrows. And then, of course, don't forget you got to get your holiday parade applications in. That's going to be right around the corner. That's the November 21st. Once again, we have the holiday parade. We're doing the theme Holidays Around the World to celebrate not only our downtown, but the fact that this is something to celebrate all over the world, and we have a great holiday parade lined up for November. I think that we've got a lot of things coming, and again, they're giving me cues here that we're going to have to shut down here real soon. Any last comments or anything that I might have forgotten, Joe?
No, just, I mean, thank you to DID, thank you to Chuck, Carl, Heidi, Jason, and Kevin at the Community Foundation. It's been a very cool experience for us because, you know, we're always doing things in our building, you know. We never really get to go outside and do really, really cool things like this. And, you know, for a community support project, it's been a very cool experience. And, you know, we hope that everybody comes out to this next one, Gin Blossoms, and then, you know, whatever we do in the future.
You're working on an event that's kind of exciting for you, and you with the wings.
Yeah, we have a wing fling coming in on September 26th. You know, a lot of people are a little afraid from coming out of Philly, the Philly area, because of the Pope. But, you know, if you have a chance to check out our Reading Wing Fling, you know, I'll give you a little teaser. It's on Groupon. You can grab some cheap tickets there. It's all you can eat wings. And then, you know, you can also check us out at Klinger's tonight, the Railroad House on Wednesday, Peanut Bar on Thursday. And finally, let's see if I get this right, on Friday, it is the Outside In, and you can get $10 tickets on site. So, you know, all you can eat wings for 10 bucks, you know, come by, say hi to us, and all you have to do is, you know, smile, and we'll give you some wings.
It's fun.
Yeah.
It's great venue. And you've got lots of big names coming up within your next couple months. Mm-hmm. I encourage people to go out on your website and check it out because you really
check out www.santander-arena.com. You know, we've got the Wu-Tang Clan coming in. We've got Nancy Kerrigan with Johnny Weir and Kurt Browning for Halloween on Ice. We've got Willie Nelson, Merle Haggard, Chris Young. I mean, and that's just the arena. You know, the Performing Arts Center's got another 25, 30 shows, starting with Dwight Yoakam in a couple of weeks and Martina McBride following shortly. So, you know, check out www.santander-arena.com for our full lineup. And I promise you won't be disappointed with this fall.
And we'll probably have a lot of more fun things to announce with some of those big names.
You bet, yeah.
And Heidi, again, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you for having me and for everything that DID and SMG are doing. Really appreciate
that. Well, we appreciate your support. It really means a lot. That has been a real, you know, boost for us to be able to get to where we are. So a lot of us have had the thoughts and hopes of being able to do this, and it takes sometimes some financials to just get it started. And We won't let you down. We'll make sure it's great.
Thank you.
And we'll see you all September 23rd for sure in downtown for Downtown Alive Outdoor Concert. And remember, it's free. So we'll see you then. Thank you, everyone. See you next month.